other point I wanted to raise, Willie, because so many people tweeted about it, like too many to mention, but thanks if you did. And something we get on the phones quite a lot, this notion that referees should declare who they support, is that doable? You'll have heard that before, I'm sure. So what's the thought there?
First of all, referees need to declare an interest. If, for example, we had a top assistant referee a couple of seasons ago, his son was playing for a senior club, even though it was under 19 level, he declared that as an interest, you know. Or if somebody works in a company who's perhaps, you know, sponsoring a particular club, they were the things that we would expect referees to declare an interest. In terms of the team that somebody might support or a connection with a family member of that, where do we draw the line? You know, we want to encourage people into refereeing and say that you can referee the top games, you can referee any match. And we would put a blocker in that. And I keep saying, where would you draw the line? Does it mean, you know, if somebody's third relative had some connection somewhere, would that be a problem? Did they have a season ticket? Did they support somebody? What I would say, Gordon, and this is where I want to be really honest with people. When you're refereeing at the top level of the game, you've got a passion, you've got a love for it. You want to continue doing it. You want to achieve well. Refereeing took me places that when I was a young kid, I never dreamed I would ever be able to go. Why would somebody jeopardise that or risk that, you know, to say, well, I want to see this team winning or I want to, you know, affect this? I'm not saying in world football it's not happened, but here I want people to trust me in saying that that's just not the case in Scotland. You know, we're barraged by comments in the west of Scotland about, you know, a bias towards one club or the other. That's not the case. People make genuine decisions. They'll make genuine errors. And we're honest, you know. If referees weren't honest, we would have a problem. And for me, I think we need to move away from that. I think it's 2024. I would ask people, whether it be the media, whether it be fans, whether it be clubs, let's shift that narrative, you know. Let's get behind referees rather than trying to say we're going to pick a fault because we think this person's associated with that or that. You know, top referees for a reason, and they've gone through a long journey to get there. And once they're there, they want to continue that and they want to take it even further.